Children, today in this lesson, we will learn the process of subtraction of two-digit numbers by writing them horizontally. One day, Raju and Bablu went to Chanda's flower shop. One garland of Chanda had 25 yellow flowers and the other garland had 14 red flowers. Bablu asked Raju, "Raju, can you tell me how many more flowers are there in Chanda's yellow flower garland than her red flower garland?" Raju scratched his head and said, "No, Bablu, I cannot tell." Then Bablu wrote the question on a paper in this manner. Raju could not understand anything. Then Bablu told him, "Raju, find out how many more flowers are there in Chanda's garland of 25 flowers than in her garland of 14 red flowers. We have to subtract 14 from 25. Now I will write 25 and 14 as tens and ones in this way. If I subtract the 4 ones of 14 from the 5 ones of 25, how many ones are we left with? 1 ones. And now what should we do? Absolutely correct. If we subtract the 1 tens of 14 from the 2 tens of 25, then how many tens will we be left with? 1 tens. In this way, Chanda's yellow flower garland has 11 more flowers than her garland of red flowers. Did you understand, Raju? Raju still could not understand clearly. Can you explain that to me with another example? Raju said to Bablu, "Let's go to Appu's sweet shop. I will give you another example there." When Raju and Bablu went to Appu's sweet shop, they saw that Appu had 36 jalebis. Then Sher Khan bought some jalebis from him and now he has 12 jalebis left. Bablu wrote a question like this on paper and asked Raju, "Look, Appu had 36 jalebis earlier. Now he has 12 jalebis. We have to find out how many jalebis Sher Khan bought from Appu." Children, can you answer Bablu's question? Let us do this together. What we are going to do first? Yes, we will write 36 and 12 as 10 and 1 token like this. Now we will subtract the 2 ones of 12 from the 6 ones of 36. How many ones are we left with now? Yes, we have 4 ones left with us. Now finally, if we remove 1 tens of 12 from 3 tens of 36, then we will have 2 tens left. We have thus got our answer. Sher Khan had bought 24 jalebis from Appu. Bablu also explained the process of subtraction to Raju in exactly the same way. Raju became very happy. He said to Bablu, "Bablu, I have understood. Now I will be able to solve the subtraction sums easily." "If that's the case, then let us go to the fair. And this time, why don't you solve some subtraction puzzles for me?" Bablu said to Raju. Raju and Bablu went to the fair. Let us see what mischiefs they do in the next chapter. Children, in this lesson, we learned the process of subtraction of two-digit numbers by writing them horizontally. Children, in this lesson, we will see some interesting examples of subtraction of two-digit numbers by writing them horizontally. Today, Raju and Bablu are walking in the fair. Raju is excited that he has now learned subtraction and he can now solve any question. Raju and Bablu went to a shop to burst balloons. There were a total of 50 balloons. Raju started bursting the balloons. When his turn got over, 11 balloons were left. Bablu asked Raju how many balloons he had burst. Bablu immediately wrote this question on a piece of paper. But Raju started thinking because he could not understand how he could possibly subtract 1 ones of 11 from 0 ones of 50. Children, do you think this is possible? Let us see how Bablu solved it. Bablu took a paper and told Raju, "Here we have to use the borrowing process. We will borrow 1 10 from 5 tens of 50 and thus make 10 ones. Because we borrowed 1 10, we have 4 tens left now." Children, can you solve this further? Yes, we will subtract 1 ones from 10 ones and we will get 9 ones. And finally, if we remove 1 tens from 4 tens, we will get 3 tens. Raju became excited after learning this new process. Oh wow! Raju burst 39 balloons. Bablu found the solution to this question just like us. A laddu eating competition was happening in the fair. Raju and Bablu also participated in the competition. Raju ate 32 laddus and Bablu ate 41 laddus. Now both are fighting over who ate more laddus and by how many. Children, can you answer this question? Wow, children, you have solved this correctly. Bablu ate 9 laddus more than Raju. Raju and Bablu kept wandering in the fair and solving the questions of subtraction. Children, you should also find such questions of subtraction around you and try to solve them. Children, in this lesson, we have seen some interesting examples of subtraction by writing 2-digit numbers horizontally. Children, in this lesson, we will look at some common mistakes that are made while subtraction of 2-digit numbers. One day, while walking around, Bhola and Golu Panda reached the confusing village of mathematics. A lot of treasure is hidden in the village. But to get it, they will have to solve the confusing puzzles of this village. They saw this subtraction written on a tree. Children, is this subtraction correct? You guessed it right. This subtraction is incorrect. Will Bhola and Golu be able to solve this correctly? Let us see. Bhola observed that in this subtraction, 3 ones of 23 were being subtracted from 4 tens of 47. Another mistake has been made by subtracting the 2 tens of 23 from the 7 ones of 47. Now Bhola erased this wrong answer and subtracted the 3 ones of 23 from the 7 ones of 47. Then, after subtracting 2 tens from 4 tens, he wrote the answer as 24. Children, is Bhola's answer correct? Yes, Bhola's answer is absolutely correct. As soon as Bhola wrote the answer on the tree, lots of golden flowers began showering down the tree. Now Bhola and Golu saw a well. This puzzle was written on the well. Children, is this subtraction correct? Yes, there's a mistake in this subtraction. Can you identify the mistake here? Absolutely correct. Here we cannot subtract the 6 ones of 36 from the 5 ones of 85. So, we have to borrow 110 from the 8 tens of 85. In this subtraction, by borrowing, 6 ones have been subtracted correctly from 15 ones. But after borrowing the 110, they forgot to reduce the 8 tens to 7 tens. So children, what will be the correct answer to this subtraction? Yes, the correct answer of this subtraction will be 49. Golu erased the wrong answer and wrote this correct answer on the well. As soon as Golu wrote the correct answer, a whole lot of toffees flowed out of the well. Golu ate a lot of toffees. Now Golu and Bhola were tired. They wanted to go home. But the exit gate was closed and there was a puzzle written on it. Can this puzzle be solved in an easy way? Let us see how Bhola and Golu find a solution to this problem. Bhola has a grid full of numbers. Children, have you seen this grid before? Yes, this grid is exactly like Bunny's 100-room house. In this puzzle, we have to find the number which, when subtracted from 67, will give 36. Bhola first took one jump down from 67 on the grid and thus by subtracting 10, he reached 57. Now he made another jump down and then subtracting 10 again. So which number did he reach? 47. Absolutely correct. Now he finally took another jump and reached 37 on the grid. Children, now how will we reach 36 from 37? Yes, we have reached 36 by walking one step towards the left. In this way, using the grid, Bhola went 31 steps back from 67 and reached 36. Bhola wrote the number 31 in the blank space. As soon as the gate opened, there appeared a shining car in front of Golu and Bhola. They sat in the car and returned home happily. Children, in this lesson, we saw some common mistakes that were made while subtracting two-digit numbers.